Bullying isn't just a problem for school children. It can happen anywhere, from church to sporting events.
And often, bullying happens in the workplace. A survey this fall by the Workplace Bullying Institute found that 49% of American workers have witnessed or suffered from bullying. One woman who now lives in Oregon took on her bullying boss and won in court. But many other American workers suffer in silence, and few laws are in place to protect them. Tonight, we continue our special series, Beating the Bullies, with a closer look at workplace bullying.
How close are you going to let me get today, huh?
Gloria Salerno spends her days enjoying the beauty of Bend. Her life is peaceful now, but it wasn't always this way.
It was my dream job. You know, this was not just a job for me. This was something that I had wanted to do.
In the mid-90s, Salerno got a job with the Italian-American Institute at the City University of New York. She was a licensed psychologist who loved working with students and being entrenched in the Italian-American community. But there was one big problem with her job, her boss. Salerno says Joseph Scalza held a grudge against her and another coworker ever since they participated in a group devoted to fighting sexual harassment. Salerno says because of that, her boss took away what she loved.
I'm a clinical psychologist. I was good with students, and he put me in a room to have me type out of college bulletins. That was what I trained for.
Salerno and her coworker went to the union, the state, and the chancellor's office, but couldn't find help. That caused the bullying to get worse. They say they were isolated, ridiculed, and punished for imagined offenses.
That was part of his bullying, to humiliate us, to show people that he had power over us, and what would happen to them if they thought about standing up to him the way we did.
Salerno says she and her coworker both suffered physical and mental health problems. They left the Institute in 1997. Then they sued. After years of legal wrangling, Salerno and her coworker settled with the university. In 2005, they walked away with more than $1 million.
We have to be an example, philosophically. You know, if we hadn't done what we did, he might still very well be there.
Bullying causes stress. The stress-related health complications are both physical and psychological.
The Workplace Bullying Institute in Bellingham, Washington, studies the problem and advocates for workers. It surveyed almost 8,000 workers this summer and found 37% of American workers, almost 54 million people, have been bullied. 72% of the bullies at work are bosses, and 57% of the time the targets are women. Right now, bullying in the workplace is not explicitly illegal. The Workplace Bullying Institute is trying to change that.
It is a health issue, too. It is a health and safety problem, and really, government should address it from that perspective.
13 states have introduced legislation outlawing bullying in the workplace, including Oregon, but so far, no states have passed a law. Gloria Salerno says that's a shame.
It's not healthy. It's not necessary. If we had the right laws protecting people who want to work, this shouldn't have ever happened.
Salerno and her former coworker are now writing a book about their ordeal. It should be out by the end of 2007, 10 years after the women left their dream job because of a bullying boss.
He may have slowed us down, but he can't stop us. That ultimately the spirit is still there and the spirit is strong.
Joseph Scalza now works at the Italian American Museum in New York. Newswatch 12 contacted Scalza and the City University of New York. They did not return our request for comment. The Workplace Bullying Institute says nurses and teachers are some of the most common targets of bullies.